The year is almost over. Spotify is getting ready to share your most listened to songs of the year. For music fans, this is an exciting time. With tools like Discover Weekly, Daylist, and the AI DJ, Spotify has perfected the art of matching users with songs they'll like. But have you ever wondered how Spotify decides what songs to recommend? And what does this mean for the future of the music industry? I'm Michael Rossetti, a data scientist and adjunct faculty member at Georgetown's McDonough School of Business. Let's earn some extra credit. Spotify uses both behavioral and non-behavioral features to perform music recommendation. First up, user behaviors. This includes a user's all-time listening history, as well as their recent listening history. So if you've listened to a lot of Taylor Swift in the past, Spotify might recommend one of her songs. Spotify also leverages the behaviors of other users in the network. This is called collaborative filtering. In this method, Spotify finds other users in the network who have similar tastes as you and recommends songs to you based on their tastes. If you listen to Taylor Swift, Spotify might look at other users and say, lots of other Swifties also listen to Meghan Trainor. So let's put some Meghan Trainor on this playlist and see if you like her as well. However, the downside with collaborative filtering is it may perpetuate popularity bias. In other words, it tends to recommend music that's already popular and may overlook hidden gems. Also, since collaborative filtering is based on user data, if you have no users, you have no data, so you may need to explore other methods. Luckily, there's another option. Non-behavioral features include musical qualities inherent in the content itself. In the case of Spotify, they've identified around a dozen different dimensions to characterize any given song. These characteristics include basic features like the song's tempo, key, time signature, and duration, and also include more abstract features like a song's danceability, energy, acousticness, and speechiness. This is possible through a subfield of machine learning known as music information retrieval, which is one of my research areas of interest. For example, if you look up September by Earth, Wind, and Fire, it ranks high in energy but low in acousticness. Whereas Someone Like You by Adele is high in acousticness, but low in energy. Like you. Content-based recommendations are great because you don't need users. The platform can identify similarities and differences in the songs and recommend songs based on the content itself. But there are a few challenges. How do you know you're choosing the right characteristics to measure a song? Users might not care about tempo or danceability in certain situations. That's why Spotify also uses contextual information, such as the time of day or type of device being used. This allows Spotify to avoid recommending a high-tempo, highly danceable club banger in the late night hours on a weeknight when you may be trying to fall asleep. Instead, Spotify can see you usually listen to soothing piano music at this time of night, so they can recommend the right content consistent with the moment. By themselves, none of these methods are perfect, but when put together, they give Spotify a pretty good sense of the music you might like. So what does this all mean for the future of music? Recently, we've seen advancements in text-based generative AI tools like ChatGPT. Although progress has been slower for audio-based generative AI models, with some advancements in this area, Spotify could begin to create new songs just for you, based on the songs you already like. This is, of course, just speculation. But as we post our Spotify Wrapped data over the coming weeks, we know one thing for certain. AI tools will undoubtedly continue to shape the content we consume, the products we buy, and the music we listen to.